So a pretty stunning claim from Russian President Vladimir Putin just a few hours ago, saying essentially there will be new chemical weapons attacks and they will be carried out to frame Syrian dictator Bashar al-Assad. Now, Putin went on to say that President Trump rushed to act too quickly.
All this is happening as the president nears 100 days in office. Joining us now, Angela Rye, CNN political commentator, former executive director of the Congressional Black Caucus, and Jeffrey Lord, CNN political commentator, contributing editor at the American Spectator. Jeffrey, let me start with you. During the campaign, candidate Donald Trump essentially said, would it be such a bad thing to have a friendly relationship with Vladimir Putin in Russia? Well, now the Russian leader is accusing the Trump administration of a war tantamount to a false invasion. And suggesting that, you know, Syria is being framed here.
Well, so much for the idea that Vladimir Putin was linked to give Donald Trump the presidency. I don't think this has worked out the way the critics have suggested. Look, I have said all along from day one, it is not possible that Vladimir Putin preferred Donald Trump over Hillary Clinton. Donald Trump is going to take, I think, Vladimir Putin and every other world leader at face value until they do something that crosses a line.
I can hear you.
And this clearly was a very disturbing incident, very, very disturbing. And he acted, he took action. And we've seen what it's like when a president does not act. So we're just gonna have to go on from here and play it as it goes.
All right, do we have Angela with us, guys?
I hear you all, I can't hear Jeffrey.
All right, Angela Rye, it's Poppy Harlow. I'm glad you can hear us. Let me ask you this. Just looking at this is certainly front and center for this administration heading into the 100-day mark, which is not really significant other than people make a big deal of it sort of since FDR. It's how is the administration judged. So heading up to the 100-day mark, this administration has had some wins like Gorsuch, et cetera, and they've had some road bumps like the failure to pass the health care reform bill, like the travel ban 1.0 and 2.0 not making it through the court system, like General Flynn's resignation. However, they've had some wins, right? They've had Gorsuch. They've had the rollback on regulations. The stock market is way up. Illegal border crossings are way down. We know that the White House communications director called this meeting last week to try to figure out, with whiteboards included, how they're going to brand the 100 days. How do you see it?
Well, I think it's important for us to decipher between how they actually are categorizing wins. I think wins are determined by how they impact the American people. So I can't help but to compare Donald Trump's first 100 days to Barack Obama's first 100 days. We're talking about Barack Obama signing the Lilly Ledbetter Act into law, which ensures equal pay for equal work for women. We're talking about someone who ensured the American Recovery and Reinvestment Act to what he said, allow rising tides to lift all boats and to strengthen the economy for people in their local areas. And then you compare that to, I think, what I would categorize as, frankly, many epic fails by the Trump administration, and that is, as you said, the Muslim ban and the various iterations of that. The wall, the fact that he said to taxpayers, okay, I'm just kidding, now actually you all will pay for the wall. The number of things, where they've had to pivot. I think the only real thing where Donald Trump has won, besides, of course, Gorsuch, and he had the Senate to help him there, thank God they implemented the nuclear option there, is golfing. He is winning on golfing, Poppy. He's 28 days out of 100 into golfing, and that's it. And it's so funny because he was the critic in chief about Barack Obama's golf game.
All right, Jeffrey Lord, I'm going to let you respond to that specifically.
Oh, I can hear
and
you
I think
this
we, time. I think we have some sound. Hang on, Jeffrey, because to Angela's point, I think we have some sound of then candidate Trump talking about golf. Let's play it.
Obama, it was reported today, played 250 rounds of golf. He played more golf last year than Tiger Woods.
This guy plays more golf than people on the PGA Tour.
Golf, 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 more, more. Learning how to chip, learning how to hit the drive, learning how to putt. Oh, I want more.
I love golf. I think it's one of the greats, but I don't have time.
I'm going to be working for you. I'm not going to have time to go play golf.
I wouldn't leave the White House very much because, you know, like little things like these little trips where they get on, they cost you a fortune.
All right, and Jeffrey, and on top of that, CNN is reporting that President Trump is on pace to spend more on personal travel in his first year than President Obama spent all 8 years that he was in office. It just so happens, I don't think there's anything wrong with presidential golfing, but Doesn't this prove that then candidate Trump was dead wrong about it when he was running for office, Jeffrey?
Nah, I don't think so. I think this is just a media gotcha.
That was a moment of
I'm still waiting.
Jeffrey Lord, how is it the media gossip? You heard the president's own words.
I'm looking for things like, did President Obama donate his first quarter salary to the National Park Service? I don't think so. Did he play golf on his own golf course? I don't think so.
That's costing us $3 million, Jeffrey, every trip. $3 million every trip.
Look, the important thing here is Neil Gorsuch. I mean, I went to some of these Trump rallies. This was something that people talked about all of the time. That's a generational change. He's going to be on that court for a very long time. This is why Angela and her friends were so upset and forced the pulling of the trigger on the nuclear option. He's had a stunning great time here. In the beginning, he is really changing America. And I might add, as the Wall Street Journal editorial has pointed out this morning, President Obama has left this country with considerable tab financially that we're going to be paying for a very long time.
Jeffrey, okay, I just have to push back on this a little bit. Again, I'm so glad you brought up the tab. Let me talk to you a little bit about that tab. $3 million per golf trip. Melania staying in New York City, $1 million a day. We're talking about, Jeffrey, you're looking at the new fiscal conservative. It's me. And I just am so surprised that you won't even agree with me on this point. You're talking about wins for the American people. I would push back. Climate change is a real thing. You talked about me and my friends. Tell your friends that there are icebergs melting, okay? We have a real challenge. And your guy is dialing back regulations that are harmful, not just to the American people, but globally. This is a problem. We have to acknowledge where there is, well, at least where there should be bipartisan agreement, and that should be on facts. Facts are non-negotiable, despite what you and your friends like to say.
Facts are non-negotiable.
Right.
And the reason Donald Trump is in the White House in the first place is because people had had it with the Obama
era. Because he said, we're going to win so much, we're going to get tired of winning.
And Jeffrey Lord, we have to go because John and I need to go golfing.
We're going to get Jeffrey's friends together, Angela's friends together, our friends together, and go golfing.
And we're going to put it on the federal government.
And we're going to put it on the federal government. We'll do that.
All right, still to come for us on a much more serious note, it is not just Putin, North Korea, lashing out this morning at the United States. It says it's ready for war. What Trump is tweeting.